Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Beyond Skyrim. I'm Amethyst Unatari. Today we'll be reading Khajiit's perspective on High Rock, which we found right here in Gautier Manor. Khajiit's perspective on High Rock, a work by Zadaki, part of his Khajiit's perspective series on the cultures of Tamriel. Purchase other installments from all good bookstores. Remember, if they don't sell it, pester the store owner until they do. This one does not know where to begin, yes? The land of Bretons, with all its varied climes and even more varied inhabitants, is truly hard to wrap one's head around. Yet this one endeavors to, in order to bring his experiences of High Rock to Khajiit, and perhaps curious men and myrrh. First, Khajiit must understand that High Rock is a very cold province indeed. A far cry from the blazing heat and gorgeous rays of elsewhere, High Rock is a chilly, rainy, and soggy province. Do you feel repulsed yet? If so, perhaps it may be prudent to stop reading. Clearly, High Rock is not for you. Second, Khajiit must understand that the Bretons are a very disparate people. They do not unite under a common banner, being instead under the jurisdiction of many kingdoms and fiefdoms, or whatever it is the Bretons have taken to calling them. There is endless politicking going on between these kings and barons and dukes. It is enough to give this one a headache as he pens this text. Does the thought of endless politics repulse you? Then, once again, perhaps this is where it may be prudent to stop reading. Khajiit will not hold it against you. High Rock is not like elsewhere at all. Indeed, when this one went to petition a duke, or whatever his title was, he was thrown out and called a scallywag. What does that word even mean? Khajiit does not know. And what did he do to deserve such an insult? So perhaps he did not take the front entrance. Yes, perhaps he did enter through the window of the duke's private quarters. But you must understand that Zadaki was feeling most energized that night after he had partaken in relations with the duke's wife a few hours earlier. Thirdly, High Rock has many foods, but not the foods that we enjoy. There is no elsewhere fondue, no sugar meats, not even any sugar scum. But there is a plentiful supply of cheese and pie and tarts, enough to cure any sweet tooth, except the strongest of all, moon sugar. High Rock, as with most provinces outside elsewhere, is distinctly lacking in moon sugar. You will only find sugar in decrepit drug dens or in the stocks of shady dealers. This is very bad for Khajiit, yes? A sweet tooth must be sated, but High Rock makes this very difficult. It is simply not the same to have one of the Breton's tarts, or pies, or buns. This, most of all, makes Khajiit sad. Does this repulse you yet? Then it is time for you to close this book and be very sorry you bought it, because High Rock is most certainly not for you. Have you made it this far without closing the book and charging into the bookstore in a frenzy, demanding a refund? Excellent. Then we can talk about what is truly good about High Rock. Has this one spoken of the delightful music the Bretons play? They play the violin and the harp and the cello. Oh, yes, indeed. They play the lute and the guitar and flute, too. Such beautiful sounds come out of their instruments. This one is in awe whenever he enters a tavern, or especially when he goes to hear the bands play on the stages. There is no shortage of flavor and frolicking to be had. This one has also a special song recommendation. Ask the musicians for the one that goes da-da-do-do-da-da-da-da-do-da-da-do-da-da-do-da-do-da-do-da-do. Khajiit sadly does not remember the song's name, but this one is sure that they will recognize it by this description. And let us speak also of the High Rock plays. While they do not have the Nirn Theatre and its diverse array of multicultural spectacles, there are more intimate plays that go on regularly in the villages, often in the taverns or within local music halls. These are normally light-hearted affairs, and they do indeed make this one chuckle very much. This one especially liked the one with the werewolf. Khajiit was shouting, "He's behind you!" so many times, but never did the poor farmer listen. This one told him not to trade the cow for the magic Nirn root as well, but he also didn't listen to that advice. This one does not fully grasp the concept of the play yet, but this one hopes to in time. Also, Bretons have the pipe, yes? They do not burn moon sugar within it, but it certainly creates, and sates, another little creature comfort. If you have read this far, you've probably decided from this one's writings whether or not Hyrok is good for you. But before this one puts down the pen and takes up the pipe, this one must tell you one thing. Don't go stealing Khajiit's pipe. Thank you for listening to Let's Read, the books of Beyond Skyrim, Khajiit's perspective on Hyrok.